Hi, Nancy here, gratefully recovering food addict, and I would like to discuss how I get through the holidays following my food plan, staying abstinent from my alcoholic foods. It's a tough time. The season of eating begins with Halloween, and it just keeps rolling through until Easter. And, you know, it's not only the holidays, it's the special foods associated with those holidays. It is the emotional component, getting together with family members that maybe we don't see that often or avoid. It's really a very tough time. But it doesn't have to be. If we have some strategies and have the right frame of mind going into things. So I would say that, I've been following my food plan for 7.5 years. So I have a few holidays under my belt. The first year going through each holiday, I would say there is somewhat of a mourning period because there are special foods that are associated with each holiday and, you know, that we've enjoyed since we were children and that bring back memories. I know every Christmas I would make this special gelatin salad that my grandmother always made, and it just reminded me of her, and it got so that no one really was eating it anymore, just me. And, you know, it had an emotional link for me, and, you know, and there are a lot of foods that way. Some foods we only splurge at, you know, we only have the Christmas cookies once a year, and so on and so forth. And then there's of course, the birthday cake. How could you ever celebrate a birthday without a birthday cake? Well, I've done it for 7 years, and I don't feel sad about it. I don't feel resentful. So what we have to do is realize, especially the first year through, we have to realize that we're human, we have emotions, we are mourning the foods. It is like a death. I can't have those alcoholic foods. It would send me straight back into food hell, and I don't want to be there. I do not want to be there again. So I hang on tight to my food plan. So that means I plan ahead and think of what situations might come up. I might even avoid going to certain parties and or cutting the time I'm there short. I don't like to go to, like a company party where that's the focus. They're just going to, you know, eat themselves to oblivion, or, you know, drink themselves to whatever, you know, happens to be, whatever floats people's boat. So I avoid that part. Say there's going to, like an Al-Anon meeting, they'll have, a party beforehand, like an hour before the meeting. I usually just skip the eating part. Or if I do go, I bring my own, of course, but, I just skip the eating part, and then just go for the meeting or the celebration afterwards. So you need to, decide for yourself. Like the big book says, ask yourself, do I have a good reason to be there, or is it just about food? If I have a good reason to be there, then... Okay, so then I want to talk about, well, we have Thanksgiving coming out and Christmas, and I want to talk about family. That can be really tough, because if you tell them or don't tell them you're on a food plan that you are following and you're feeling better and you want to stick to it, They've heard that a lot of times from you, and don't really think, well, we don't know what they think, but you know, they've heard it from you before and they've seen you indulge anyway. So talk is cheap. It's the action. So what I do if I'm going, say, to a family get together, I'll find out what they're having. And we have to be careful because people, we prepare things in a certain way in our kitchen, and other people are not, you know, they don't have to be so vigilant reading labels and whatnot. So they might prepare the same dish, but differently than you do. Like one time I found that canned chopped tomatoes had high fructose corn syrup in it. I don't know what on earth possesses the, I won't say the name of the company, but I think I know which one it is, to put high fructose corn syrup in tomato, chopped tomatoes. It just boggles my mind, but it's harder and harder to find clean prepared foods. Anyway, so they're not always going to be preparing the foods the way that you would to be safe. And so I usually bring my own or just bring the components. And if there's like clean roasted turkey, I'll have that and add my own starch, or, you know, the mashed potatoes are made because I weigh and measure, and I need to measure the oil. I don't use butter, so, you know, even mashed potatoes. And sometimes I'll ask my mom, just leave, you know, a bunch. I have 8 ounces of potato for a serving. Just leave out 8 ounces of potatoes before you mash them, and that'll be mine, and I'll, you know, dress them up myself. Like I said, if it's really emotional, you know, really emotionally draining to be around family or your people that you spend the holidays with, limit the time. You don't have to be there from, you know, 4 hours. You can go a little bit before dinner and then maybe help a little with the cleanup and then say, you know, I've got to go. I know people in Al-Anon do that with their drinking family members. They, you know, they time it. So when stuff starts getting a little iffy. Okay, and then there's the aunt, Hilda, who always makes this special dish, and it's your favorite. And you feel that you might hurt her feelings if you don't have some. Well, there are a few ways we can go about it. What I say now is, thank you, that's very nice, but I have this allergy food plan that I follow. It is an allergy to my alcoholic foods. I cannot eat them. You know, someone says, oh, don't you want some of this? You know, you can make up a lot of excuses, but it's better just to tell the truth. I don't eat sweets anymore. And you don't have to go into elaborate detail. The shorter, the better. And you just keep saying that over and over every time it's offered to you. Yeah, it's delicious. I know I've really loved it in the past, but I don't eat sweets anymore. I find that I just can't, you know, it's bad for my health. I just can't do it. And, you know, they'll make comments about, oh, I wish I could do that, or, oh, you're so strict. It's the holiday. Why, just, you know, just this one time. Well, I know, because from trial and error, from decades of trying, I personally cannot have, say, sugar, anything sweet, not even a bite. I'll be back in food hell. And I know that for sure. I have no question in my mind at this point. So I stay away from that. And, you know, it may take a few years for it to sink in, but they see you sitting down, having your healthy meal each gathering, and They're going to leave you alone after a while. You say, well, she eats healthy. What can we do? And you can bring a dish, you know, a healthy side dish or whatever, and join in. Let's see, what else did I want to say? So the emotional part. Oh, and if things get kind of tense. So, yeah, we can't go into this, even if it's been like 5 years and they know how you eat. And you go, you can't expect other people to have things at the meal that are clean for you to eat. You cannot expect them to be thinking about you and your food plan. They've got enough to worry about if they're putting on a big meal. Your abstinence is up to you. Your health is up to you. So don't depend on other people. You bring what you need and take care of yourself. Oh, let's see, what was the other thing? So if things get kind of intense, say it's the middle of the meal and, you know, people, family, they know how to push your buttons, and things are getting really kind of hairy, you can excuse yourself, go into the bathroom, take some deep breaths, think about, you know, maybe they're in their food addiction, they're high, mean, you know, are drinking and getting kind of mean, and just remind yourself that they're not in recovery. They don't have the tools that you have. They don't have the perspective that you have. They're sick. Treat them as you would any sick person. And if you do get a little heated, you know, forgive yourself. You're human. They know how to push your buttons, even if they don't mean to. They don't mean to. It's just certain topics come up every holiday. Things happen. And then dessert. Okay, I love to bake. I can cook dessert, I can cut it, I can serve it, but I really don't like sitting there watching people eat dessert. And some can have fruit at that meal. I don't have fruit at my main meal. I have it at breakfast and in the evening. So I don't, what I do with my family, because it's kind of an open concept, I serve the dessert because I enjoy doing that and I'm good at it. And then I start cleaning up in the kitchen. And my mom used to get upset with me, say, come sit down, everyone's sitting, come join us. And it's just while people are eating their dessert, and then when they're done, I just come and sit down, have a cup of tea or what, you know, and that works out really well for me. You find your own way. And then another way, before or after the meal, get outside, take a little walk, get some fresh air, deep breaths. If there's someone that you've missed seeing, maybe invite them to come along with you, or maybe you just want to be by yourself for a little bit. Regroup, get your thinking back into a more positive frame of mind instead of, you know, being resentful. Oh, this one always. And another thing you can do before the holiday or before the meal is your frame of mind is so important. Okay, so you know, Aunt. Our Uncle Joe does this certain thing every year and it pisses you off and you say, why does he have to do this every year? Well, go into it knowing that he's probably going to do this. He's going to say something uncomfortable or mean or, you know, he's just going to be Uncle Joe. Accept it. Uncle Joe's going to do that. no reason to get all angry about it, get all bent out of shape. Let him, maybe he just likes to get a rise out of people, you know, and if he doesn't get that reaction, he'll stop doing it. So just go into it knowing, you know, certain people are going to be doing certain things because that's what they do every year, every time you get together, and accept it. Say, I can't change them, but I can change the way I react to it. That's definitely in your power. So is it possible to stay on your food plan? Yes, it is. Don't go into it thinking, oh, I don't know if I'll be able to do it. It's so tempting. Just go into it feeling I'm strong. I've got some abstinence behind me. I'm not going to feel sick and tired and angry and crappy. That's not what the holiday's about. The holiday isn't about the food. The holiday is getting together with people we love to be with, even if it's family that we don't get along with. We feel obligated. You know, you can look at that too. Am I really obligated to show up at that meal if it's just soul-sucking? Maybe I can skip it once, you know, and maybe not go both Thanksgiving and Christmas, just one or the other. In recovery, we need to take care of ourselves. No one's going to take care of us. We need to take care of ourselves and do what's right for us and go into these situations with the right mind frame that that I'm strong. Other people, listen, if I could do it, you can do it. I know you can. Other people manage and have fun. I have more fun now because I'm not all logy, beating myself up about what I've eaten, what I want to eat, what I shouldn't eat. I do get a little testy when people after the meal sit around, oh, I wish I hadn't eaten all that. Oh, if you don't want, you know, don't eat it. you know, I'm the boss of me now. Food, holiday food, family, emotional situations are not the boss of me anymore. I am the boss of what I put in my mouth, my thoughts that I think, my reactions to situations. So that's all about all I can think of right now, but you can do it, and it's really not that difficult. You just have to get through the first one, the first season of eating, and boy, won't you feel great after Easter, even when those jelly beans are still on sale and you just pass them by because you're loving life and living it to the fullest and not living for food. It's a beautiful thing. God bless.